And this guy's like, ah, oh. This chick. She's like, thank God, somebody help me. I'm dying. Check that out. Sick bay. We can take a up close view. That's cool. What's up, guys? I'm Nos. Welcome to Planet Base. This is another space box. Space box. Another space sandbox. Simulator, space simulator, sandbox, whatever you want to call them. I'm going to start a new game. As you can see down here, these are like little achievements. I have played this before. I didn't want to come into this a total idiot, so, because it's pretty challenging. But this game is really fun. I shall name my base Nos 1. Okay, so we're going to start on the easy planet. That was that first one I chose here. Medium-sized desert planet with a thick CO2 atmosphere which partially protects it from meteors and solar flares. Has a high amount of light, solar panels operate at full capacity, suitable for wind turbines, a high risk of sandstorms, low risk of solar flares, low risk of meteors. Boom, so it's very similar to space-based... Wow, while loading, my frame rate just dies completely. Don't mind my little crazy hair. I don't know what's going on. Man, my face is really washed out looking too. Maybe I'll kill a light. Okay, so I start out with 7... I believe, yeah, 7 colonists and 2 little robots. One's a carrier bot, one's a constructor bot. This dude will carry shit around, this guy will build things. Now, first thing I need to do is take a look around. Ooh, nice, wide open area. So I need to make sure I maximize my space, my building space. So I'm going to build out this direction. My like speed. Something seems amiss. I forgot how to do stuff. Hold on. Camera components, text milestones, blah blah blah. I need controls. Tell me the controls. I just want to know how to pause. It's just... Yeah. Well, I guess no pause for me. Let's get going. First thing I need to build... Oh! There's an airlock. Let's put it really close to my little base thingy here. My people will need oxygen. Build out into this direction, so where's the best spot to do that? I think I can build over these giant rocks right here, but not over these little mounds. We'll see. Go ahead, put that here, connect it. Next thing we're gonna need is power right away. Lickety split. So let's get a solar panel going. Rotate around here so I can see what the fuck I'm doing here. Now we need a way to store power. And we need water. So we'll get those going. Water to make the oxygen extractor work. It's going to be kind of in the way over there. That should be a good spot for that. And storage for power. This guy right here. And now we need some backup power. We need a wind turbine in case, well, not in case, for when the sun goes down. And we'll just go ahead and put this over here. Because why the hell not? All that's over there is mountainous terrain. So, okay. Speed shit up a little bit. I know how to do that. Full speed ahead! Okay, come on, dudes. Get that oxygen going. So you can go in there and not die. That would be good. Okay, Jesus. I got a billion hints going on here. Yeah, I know how to play. I don't want to read all this. Just go away. Good. We're good. There we go. And as you can see, now everybody's going inside, so we have oxygen. So, next thing I'm going to build is a canteen. So everybody has a place to go chill and eat and all that shit. Now, there we go. Tab button makes my little domes go away so I can see inside. Now, as you can see, it is nighttime and my solar panels aren't doing anything, but I've got a storage, power storage here. Ooh, and this is not hooked up. That's not doing me any damn good. Look at this. Love this. You can see the reflection of the stars in the sky. Okay. Woohoo! Man, this game is speedy! Now, let's edit the contents of this canteen. Let's slow things down a little bit, too. Good God. Okay, the people need a table to sit at. There you go. Water, very essential to life. And we will need a meal maker so they can make food. And just like Space Base DF9, you gotta keep your people happy with a little bit of entertainment, so there's a television. Okay, I think we're good there now. Oh look, we've almost survived our first night, I think. Yep, we're getting close. Speed the game up a little bit. Now the next thing my people are really going to be anxious to have is a place to fucking crash. So I better get that going quick. Just squeeze you in as close as we can right there. Boop. Connect you right there. And just to make sure we don't fucking run out of power. Might need more power real soon. The sun will be coming up. So maybe solar power? By the time I get that shit done, the sun will probably be up, so. As you can see here, this shows me the time of day, whether it's day or night. This shows me the wind speed, wind strength. Tells me how many bots I've got, and colonists. So far, nobody's died. That's good. People will die. Just like on Space Base DF9. Shit'll hit the fan at some point. At least on this game, the colonists won't be killing each other constantly. Oh, what is this down here? Oh no! Can't. Oh, my face is in the way. What is this? Okay. It's a little button to check out my whatever I have selected, I guess. Cool. Survival reached! First achievement. One day after landing, your people are still alive. So we're doing good. So I think with all these little space building sandbox games, I'm going to play each one for somewhere around like 30 to 45 minutes just because it's the nature of the beast of these games. They're really slow paced. It takes at least that long to get anything accomplished. So I do believe I have two more similar games I'm going to be playing. So be on the lookout for those. If you don't like games like this, I have plenty of other games on my channel you can check out. If you do like games like this, awesome. Me too. I freaking love space building simulator type games. Just any kind of building simulator. Building and survival stuff. I dig it. Okay, all my people are kind of... This dude's thirsty. These guys are dying of exhaustion. Come on, dudes. Get that hallway done. We need to get this room full of beds. Oh, that's right. I can hold shift and do this more than once. Okay, that's enough beds for the people I have right now. Now here, we can flip this with Alt. It'll show us how much of all of our resources we have. There's quite a bit of resources you gotta keep track of eventually on this one. You need medical supplies to keep your people healthy, bioplastic to do a lot of building, metal, obviously, to build things. Spares is what you use to repair anything. And we will get plenty more on this list as we go. So one of the most important things to do right off the bat is build enough of your base to start sustaining your own shit, you know. You gotta get your own metal and bioplastic resources going. Bioplastic is made from leftover plant matter, and metal we just mine right out of the ground here. So it's usually a good idea to get some of that shit going right off. I do believe the most important thing I could be doing right now is making a biodome. I have learned that it is tough to make enough food early on unless you make... Yeah, that's a good spot. Unless you make a large biodome. At least it is for me, I don't know. If you're an ace at this game, maybe you can keep your base going with just a little tiny one, but not me. Okay, now that I have that, let's go ahead and make a mine near my entrance here so we can get metal as well. But that's not going to do us any good if we can't process it, so the next thing we'll do is we'll expand over this way and build a little place to process the metal and the bioplastic. Let's go check these guys out. Are they all crashed? Aw, poor dudes. They worked their little tails off. Good little colonists. Yeah. Speed shit up. Time to get up! Time to go back to work! This guy's like, fuck that, I'm going to bed. Man, you guys' sleep schedule is going to be all fucked up now. Sorry, my camera's like zooming all over the place. It's really touchy. I don't know why. Maybe because Bandicam's running. And my face is super washed out. Hold on. Let's try that. Kill some lighting. I don't know if that did anything. I still look like Casper. Casper the friendly... Hillbilly. Because for whatever reason I'm talking like a hillbilly. Weird. I just like made this room a lot darker. But I don't look any different. Whatever. It's because I'm so heavenly, angel-like. And stuff. One thing I also learned from experience playing this is don't build very fast. Except at the beginning, you gotta build a whole bunch of shit right off the bat, obviously. But don't expand your base too quickly, and always, always, always build way more power stuff, you know, more power generating equipment than you think you might need, because you will need it. So as you can see right now, I just doubled my power output, and I'm gonna get another one of these little doohickeys. That's a good place for you. You should recycle the colony ship. I should. That's another thing you can do. Boom. See, now I got some extra metal and I think bioplastic as well by recycling that thing. And I'll just leave it out here on the ground because I don't have any place in my base to put it. You have to build storage. But it does wear out. Oh, you can't see it. I think down here where my face is blocking shit, it shows how long this stuff lasts. But luckily all the stuff down here will last for ages and ages. The stuff you start with lasts forever. Okay, I don't know why I'm not making stuff in here yet, because I'm a dummy. Nope, nope, nope. Wheat. Yes. First thing I like to do is make some wheat, because you need starchy plants. These ones up on the top row are all starchy, to make bioplastic. These ones here grow faster, but I need lots of bioplastic, so we'll start with that. Speed things up a little bit, and we'll see if we can maintain a homeostasis here. Oop, turn this way. Like I said earlier, I will definitely be needing a processing plant to make use of the metal I'm mining and the bioplastic I'm going to be harvesting. So we'll get that going. Alright, looks like we're doing really good. My face is blocking all sorts of shit. Maybe I should move it over here next time. I don't know. There's like no good place on these games to put my damn face. Oh well. So yeah, there's pertinent information down here. Pretty sure we can get by without it though. Hint: resources. You will need to manage a variety of resources. Here we go. Here's where it shows all the resources you can end up with. And we will have all of them at some point. I'm not going to read them all, because I have, like, the most monotone, boring voice of all time. Except when I purposefully make my voice whack-a-doodle-doo. Food stocks are low. Yeah, because you guys are taking forever to build your food shit. Get your food shit going, you dumbasses. Jeez. Okay, this room is done. Let's go ahead and add ore processor thingy and a bioplastic maker thingy. We need thingies and stuff. Okay, I think we almost have enough base built to kind of advertise that we're here and attract more colonists. Let me see, where's my screen for that? Not charts. Here it is. Stats. So here's my base. Here's my coordinates for my base. My status, good. My prestige, it's like how well I'm known throughout the galaxy or the universe. This tells about the people and the bots and the resources I've got. Basically, if this shit's not good or better, nobody's gonna come. So self-sufficiency reached. Hooray! It's our second little achievement. You now have the structures in place to sustain your colony. So we're doing good. Can I go back to the game now? Please? Thank you. So I'm gonna slow things down to about double speed. So we're doing good. We've got a place for them to eat, a place for them to sleep. They've got water, oxygen, power. They're mining. They're making bioplastic. We're doing great. What's next? I think they recommend that one of the next things you should add is your sick bay. How am I doing on resources? Doing really good. Okay, sick bay it is. I hope that's a good decision. Now, another thing I learned from experience on this game, certain rooms you cannot extend from. They are dead-end rooms. They say right on them, too. Probably right here where my face is blocking everything. But, like dorms, you cannot add another room on the end of the dorm. There's only one way in, one way out of a dorm. Same with, I think, the sick bay. This room here, the factory, or whatever it's called, you can extend off of. Most of your big production rooms, you can. You definitely can off of this room, and my all-time favorite is the oxygen rooms, because they serve a dual purpose. They produce oxygen, and you can add up to, I think on the bigger ones, the bigger oxygen rooms, you can add up to like 6 branches off of them. So, they're a great way to extend your base. Another thing you got to think about is the only way they can build stuff is from outside. So if you get your base, you know, built up a little bit like we have now, it's a lot further away for them to come build out here. So one thing that's not a bad idea to do once you get about this big or a little bigger is make another airlock so that they can get in and out of the base over here as well. Also, they have to repair everything that you build outside, like the water and the power stuff. And if you have more than one way in and out of your base, it makes it a lot easier for your colonists to get shit. So, man, we're just doing excellent. Let's go ahead and add factory. Factory. Check it out. Yeah. Create processed goods from basic resources. We'll connect it here. But I don't think I can make 2 connections. Now, it's nice to have lots of different paths. All the different rooms, but sometimes you just can't. So now if I'm going to branch off from here, it's going to have to be through this little patch of rocks. I'm going to eventually have stuff clear out to here. It's going to be awesome. This game is pretty cool. I think they did a really good job on it. Although, I could think of many, many more additions that they could add to this game. I don't foresee any more major updates coming to it, but it would be cool. But as it stands, I do believe it's all a finished product. It's been out for a while, and it's a great game. It doesn't need any more added to it, but like I said, I could think of a lot of cool shit you could do with this game. Just to expand upon it. Maybe it'll do well and they'll make a badass sequel. Speed shit up. I don't know why I'm not doing that. Yay, build me stuff. Manufacturing limits. Manufacturing's limit. Okay, that just you can set how many of certain things you want them to make before they quit making more. So here I can make spares, which is a very, very, very important thing. If you run out of spares, you can't fix like shit like your solar panels and your water pump or generator. And if that happens, you're fucked. You die. So. I like to get that built pretty darn quick. Okay. I think the next thing that needs to be built is another oxygen generator for me to branch my base off from. There we go. We'll stick with a small one for now. So I don't want to use up too much of my resources. Get that shit built, dudes. I think once I get this done, once I get this part of the base done, I'm gonna go ahead and build a spaceport, or whatever they call it. Let's see, what is that called? Landing pad, so we can attract more colonists. I want a shit ton more, but a few more hands for, you know, getting shit done. That'd be nice. Another thing I need is a lab. Can I really connect it right here? And right here? No. Damn. Oh, I can! Hooray! Oh, looks like we are running low on water. That's because the lab and the sick bay, I do believe, use up a lot of water. And definitely my, whatchacallit here does. My Biodome, which is a hilarious movie, by the way. Old movie, silly movie, pretty funny movie. At least it was when it first came out, as far as I remember. I haven't seen it for a long time. Man, look at him go. I got that shit built quick. It's taking you guys so long to build this. And what's going on? Is this not powered or is it just dark? It looks dead! Speaking of powered, definitely going to want to add more power. I like to build all my power shit just kind of along the edge of the hills and mountains. That way I save all this big wide open space for adding my base. Come on, dudes. Come on, little duders. What's going on here? Oh, I've got hurt people. I've got dudes with broken bones. Okay. We can fix this. Totally forgot to add my beds. One here. There we go. Just trying to make them nice and straight. Because I'm OCD like that. See, now people that are injured like that, have broken bones, they won't work until they're healed. So, what do you want to bet that they're the guys that build shit? Can my constructor bot build that shit? God damn it. Yeah, they can't get healed until your sick bay is up and running with some beds. And it's telling me here, security controls, you can, once you have a control center, comm center built, you can tell people, hey, there's a fucking sandstorm coming, get your asses inside, and you can put the place on lockdown. But as of right now, I'm not far enough to have that luxury, so people just need to be smart and stay inside. Come on, somebody please come build this shit. There's gotta be somebody who can build. Let me take a look here. I might have screwed myself and backed myself into a corner somehow already. Let me take a look. Yeah, that's what I want. Stats. I have 3 workers, 2 biologists, 1 engineer, and 1 medic. So, You must be a worker, your worker. Or are you guys the engineers? You guys are the engineers. Huh. Is that the only people that can build this thing? Does it even say? No. It doesn't say. Great Scott! Fuck. I thought I was doing great. I may be screwed. Speed it up a little bit and watch, see what happens. This may be the end of Space Base already. Come on, peeps. See, nobody's gonna build. Because... Okay, we're gonna have to do something drastic to save this shit. Let's recycle that. That'll give me some more bioplastic. And let's recycle... What do I get out of this? 1 and 3, huh? Let's not do that. Let's go ahead and recycle this. And this for now. So that I have some materials. What do I need to build these beds? One bioplastic. Okay. So we should be okay. Somebody should come build one anytime now. Maybe. Come on! Somebody come build the fucking bed so my dudes can get healed. Thank you, God. Now this guy is like, ah! Oh. This chick. He's like, thank God. Somebody help me. I'm dying. Check that out. Sick bay! We can take a up close view. That's cool. Okay, now we're back on track. We're not totally screwed, thank God. Only because I have backed myself up against a wall like that before and kind of learned how to save my skin in situations like that. Definitely need more people. Like ASAP. Let's go ahead and add another bunk again. Now, before I go adding all that shit, maybe I should go ahead and make my Kuzuma watch it. The thingy, the doohickey, the landing pad. Yeah, that's what I meant. That's what I said. Fucking build that shit, man. I need more people. Speed it up. Full speed ahead, Captain. Man, sorry, I've been looking down this whole time. I get in the zone in these games. I'm gonna need to raise my screen up. So I'm looking up more into the camera. Bunk has been built. Thank you. How about this? What do we need for this? It tells me down here, I'll bet you. Damn it. Looks like my face is gonna have to go, like, in the middle over here. I don't know. Maybe I should just leave my ugly mug out of it. Okay, so we have this. and I can't fucking click on it because my face is in the way. That's alright. I do believe the control for all of that shit is like right here. Stats, charts, limits, text, milestones. Oh, yeah, right here. Landing permissions. Oh. It's not even built yet. What am I tripping? Fucking sure looks built. I see it. Come on, duders. Or do we need more metal? Got lots of ore chilling out here. Maybe what I ought to do is shut down the mine for a few. So you guys will quit going in there and breaking their bones. That's where your guys get broken bones, by the way. From working in the mine. That's why it's a good idea to make mining robots as soon as you can. It saves your people from getting hurt all the damn time. Zing, zip, zow. Man, this thing is touchy and speedy. Whee! Are taking forever. It's this guy right here. Here he comes. Zoom. There you go, boss. Here's your thingy. You stupid little constructor bot. He just went back inside. Now he's probably going to come back out and build it. Because I think that's all it needs is the two. No, probably needs like four. Damn. Let's just keep it at full speed. Okay, little robot put some more ore in the machine so we can make some more metal. Yep, my face is right in the way, I think, of where it shows me the progress. Oh well. I guess I don't really need to keep that shut down. The technicians are the guys that make this stuff, I think. No, it's workers. So yeah, let's keep that shut down so that they'll make more metal instead of mining more ore. Just need dudes making metal. And of course, to make another metal processor takes more metal. Stupid! Makes sense though, whatever. Whatever! Okay, one more, I think. I think it takes four. Four metal I-beam box crate things. Look at all this room we're gonna have to build in. It's not infinite, as you can see. Camera's backed up against the wall here, the invisible wall. So I can't go too far out this way. That is pretty restrictive. Oh, it's built. But yeah, I've still got plenty of space. So, let's go to landing permissions and say who the fuck can come when and where. Nope, not there. Here. Here. We want both colonists and traders. And sure, we'll just leave this at default for now. But here's where you can say, I want 40% of the colonists that I allow in to be workers, 30 biologists, 20, 10, and 0 for guards for now, because I don't really need any guards yet. As we progress, we'll fuck with that later. Right now, I don't give a shit who comes, as long as some people come. Go ahead and open the mines back up. Now we'll worry about adding. Goddamn camera. Touchy, touchy. Now we'll add this stuff back over here. Let's see, what was it? An oxygen generator. Right about here. And we also had. What was it? The laboratory? It was. I have the lab right here. We'll connect it to both. Again, if it'll let us. Yay! Expansion reached. You managed to get new colonists to arrive at your base. Hooray! Third milestone reached. Doing really good. And I should knock on wood, because it seems like whenever I start saying that, something goes awry. Speaking of, I know for a fact I need more fucking power. Let's get a larger solar panel up. Oh, not quite that big. Can we kind of stick it up against the mountain a little closer than that? Not really. Ooh! Jesus! We got lots of room over here. Power storage is low. See, I told you. Fucking knew it. Then again, that said power storage. That's not really anything to do with my power production. But you can't get your storage up if you don't have the production. But I think it's also an issue with my power capacity. Go ahead and add a bigger power storage doohickey over here. Think of it as a giant fucking battery to power your shit at night. Oh, did we get more colonists? Yay, we got more colonists. So now we're up to 9? That's it? Okay, so I've gotten 2 more colonists. Yay. So that means my food production is going to need to increase. Let's get some more wheat pads. At least one. Some more maters. We'll go 2 maters. 3 more. Oh! Didn't like that. Oh, and that was rice. Wait! Oh! Fuck off. I didn't want rice. Why, you might ask? Because I read somewhere online and then I tested the theory. But if you just make a whole shit ton of wheat and tomatoes, and then I don't even think the tomatoes have anything to do with it, but if you make a lot of wheat, you get lots of bioplastic production. And once you can make vitro meat, that's the artificial meat in the game, your guys will make hamburgers, and that keeps people happy and well fed. And it seemed to work, so I'm gonna stick with that strategy. Doesn't mean that's the only food you should make, but that's the majority of the food you should make and what you should start with. If you want to test the theory anyway. If not, I really don't care. But I tried it, and it definitely made an improvement on my food production. Like, seriously, I was struggling before to keep enough food for my people, like, no matter what. I had like 3 biodomes on one game I was trying. I think one of them was the second to largest, and the other 2 were like this size, the second biggest one. And I couldn't make enough food to keep like 20 people alive. Once I switched to this method, no problem. I had food literally like filling the whole goddamn room and the storage room. So I like this method. Did I get my power plant built yet? No. Come on, duders. Get that shit done. Oh, we're running out of power. So we have a trade vessel here. Oh, and the Goliath turbine patent is up for grabs right off the bat. You bastards. So basically, there's some really special patents you can get to build some really cool stuff, like the Goliath turbine. And, they're very expensive. So what you want to do is you build up your stock of all of your resources, and when you feel like you've got enough that you can get rid of some, you offload it to the traders in exchange for other supplies you might be short on, which is the first thing you should be looking at, especially things like spares and medical supplies. And if you don't need any of that, you get coins for it. Once you get a whole bunch of coins, you can start buying these really somewhat rare and cool patents and whatnot. But I'm in no position to do anything of the sort right now, so I'm going to send him away. Sorry, Mr. Trader, I don't have enough resources to spare. Excuse me. Yeah, I am like taking forever to get anything going here. What's going on? You need repaired. You have a broken bone. Okay. Why are my guys not making metal fast enough? What's the dealio? Let's go ahead and make another one of these. Seem to be doing fine on keeping up with the bioplastic. Well, I wanted to get these rooms done before I ended it, but I've been playing for quite a while and I've got quite a bit accomplished. So I feel really good about stopping it right here. I'm just gonna go ahead and slow it down since I can't remember how to pause the damn game. My controls for pause are probably down here. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and join me in the next episode for some more Planet Base. Eventually, we're going to have this whole area filled up with all sorts of cool space base, planet base. And, I don't know, maybe we'll play this through all three of the different worlds. They get pretty challenging, but I feel like I'm getting fairly proficient at it. I'm definitely learning the ropes. So, I hope to see you guys in the next episode. Thank you.